I think probably one of our favorite passages and one of our favorite stories is the Book of Esther. After Esther has been appointed the queen, after she has found favor with the king, Haman issues out a decree that's basically going to kill all the Jews. So her uncle, Mordecai, who has raised her pretty much her entire life, is a Jew. She is a Jew. He goes to Esther and he says, "You're in a position here, like you're the queen. You need to go to the king." Whenever we're put in positions of, I guess, leadership, or any time we're asked to do something, there's always risks. There's always things that we could lose. There's always things that we might not have when at the end of this. And I think with Esther, you know, and she knew, if I have to go before the king, like no one could come before him unsummoned. Unless he summoned them, if they came before him and he didn't raise his gold scepter to them, they died. Immediately, they died. I think Esther knew I could go before him and I could be killed before I even get the words out of my mouth. And that's the reality of it. You might not even get to say what you're there to say, but you know, if you're called to do something, you still have to go there. Esther 4:14 says, "And who knows, you may have gained your royal position for such a time like this."
Ultimately, it came down to, like, can you just hide and pretend you're one thing and not stand up for what you believe when you're given the chance and you're given the opportunity? And I think that Mordecai's words were exactly what she needed to hear to inspire her, you know, that to just sit there and let this opportunity go away would probably end up in regret for the rest of her life.
Basically, she comes to the conclusion, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to try to save my people if I can. And the ending line is, if I die, I die. And I think it's a pretty powerful passage, being able to put yourself into God's hands and let him control it no matter what the circumstance. I think there's many times it would be easy to just say, you know what, it's just too much, I can't do it. I'm just gonna sit quietly. And we may get through doing that. You'll get through life and everything, but think about the people's lives who are affected by those choices. That's the thing, our choices that we make, they don't just affect our lives. It's not just us. With Esther, it was an entire people group that was going to be affected by this one decision. I think in studying the Book of Esther and studying Esther's life, I oftentimes try to put myself into her position. I try to think, you know, what was she going through? I know there would have definitely been times throughout this whole process that I would have felt like it was all too much for me. There would have definitely been why me moments. Can't somebody else please do this? Can't someone else please solve this problem? Because, you know, I can't, it's too big, it's too much. I can't have the whole weight of an entire people, all of the Jews on my shoulder.
You know, I think that each one of us gets faced with days and moments of knowing that there's a choice and there's a right and wrong. And sometimes it's a big enough feeling that we know that right now, I wish I didn't have to do this. I wish I didn't have to make this choice. I wish I wasn't the one leading this thing. I wish I wasn't the one, you know, with like, this maybe being the role model.